Hello friends, welcome back to ProHut IT Services. Good to see you back. In this video, we'll cover the steps of installation and configuration of Citrix XenApp 6.5 server. Let's understand the roles and servers that we need to provision. To start with, we need a domain controller for authentication and for centralized management. We'll use domain users to access published applications. We'll name domain controller as DC01. We'll name second server as CTX01. We'll install Citrix XenApp on this server, that is Citrix Management Console. In addition to that, we'll install Citrix License Server role on this server. Citrix XenApp also requires a database server. We'll install database on this server and use it as Citrix Datastore. As we want our Citrix environment to be load balanced, therefore, we'll provision another Citrix server. We'll name this server as CTX02. We'll install Citrix Management Console on this server. To access published applications, a website is required. Authenticated users will browse this website to access published applications. We'll provision another box as Web Interface Server. We'll name it as WI01. A client machine is required to access published applications. We are using Win7 for this practical, and even we'll name it the same, that is Win7. Let's start with the fun part of installation and configuration. We are on CTX01 server. To start with, insert DVD of Citrix XenApp 6.5. Click on Start. Click on Computer and right click on DVD drive and select install or run program from your media. Click on yes to allow an executable to run. Click on install XenApp server. It is asking to deploy .NET 3.5 SP1. .NET 3.5 SP1 is a prerequisite for Citrix XenApp installation. Click on OK to install .NET 3.5 SP1. Citrix XenApp Server Role Manager window will start after .NET installation is completed. Click on Add Server Role to install Citrix roles on the server. XenApp has three editions that we can see on the screen. That is Platinum Edition, Enterprise Edition, and Advanced Edition. Select the edition for which you have purchased the licenses. Platinum is actually for the most complex environment. For this practical, we'll select Platinum Edition. Read the license agreement carefully, and if you agree, then click on I agree and click on Next. On the Choose XenApp Role window, select the role that you wish to install. We'll install XenApp Management Console and Citrix Licenses role on this server. Therefore, select License Server and XenApp and then click on Next. On Choose Role Subcomponents window, you can select optional components that you wanted to install. We'll select XML Service IIS Integration under Optional Components. As you know that IIS runs on port number 80. By selecting this option, we are allowing XML Service to share port 80 with IIS. If you want to assign different port to XML, then you can leave it unchecked. License Server Core, XenApp Server, XenApp Management, and Windows Desktop Experience Integration are checked as default components. For this practical, we'll integrate XML service with IIS. On the Review Prerequisite window, it shows all prerequisites that are required to be deployed before we start deploying XenApp role. Click on Next. As the installation will take a while, I'll fast forward this installation. Prerequisite requires restart. Let's restart the server and then resume the installation. Restart is completed. Click on Start, click All Programs, select Citrix Server Role Manager. To resume installation, click on Resume Install. On Ready to Install window, click on Install to resume installation. Installation will take a while. I'll fast forward this installation. As we can see, that installation is completed successfully. Click on Finish to close the window. On the Citrix XenApp Server Role Manager window, we can see both roles that we have installed on the server. That is Citrix License and XenApp Role. As per sequence, we need to configure Citrix licenses first. To configure Citrix License Server, click on Configure under License Server. On the License Server Configuration window, we can see three options. First, License Server Port. Second, Vendor Daemon Port. Third option is Management Console Web Port. We'll discuss all these options in detail in future videos. For this video, just remember the License Server Port, that is port number 27000. We need to remember this port number while configuring Citrix XenApp Server. Set the admin password. Uploading Citrix licenses are out of scope for this video. We'll discuss the same in future videos. On the Citrix XenApp Server Role Manager, we can see that Citrix license is configured. Next step is to specify licensing on Citrix Server. Click on Specify Licensing. On Citrix License Configuration, type Name of License Server. As we have installed license on the same server, therefore we'll type this server name, that is CTX01. License Server Port is 27000. We have seen the same while configuring License Server. Click on Test Connection to confirm the connectivity. Connection seems to be successful. Click on Close to close the window. Click on Next. We'll see an error that no product license is found on License Server CTX01. This is because we have not uploaded any licenses on License Server. We can ignore this error message and click on Continue. On Select Licensing Model window, we can select the type of licenses that you want to use. As we are installing XenApp, therefore we'll select XenApp and click on Apply. We'll see similar license file related error. We'll ignore the same and click on Continue. Next step is to configure Citrix XenApp Server. Click on Configure. To configure Citrix XenApp, we need to create a Citrix farm. Citrix farm is a collection of Citrix XenApp Server. As this is new installation, therefore, we need to click on Create a new server farm. Second option, that is, add this server to an existing server farm, is to load balance our Citrix environment. We'll talk more about this option in future videos. Click on Create a new server farm to create a new server farm. Type the farm name that you want to define. We'll use the default farm name, that is new farm, for this practical. Define the Citrix administrator. We are logged in as TU1 user. TU1 user is actually a domain admin. For this video, we'll consider TU1 as Citrix admin. Citrix farm requires a database. It contains all the static information, example, farm configuration, published application configuration, server configuration, etc. We'll install database on this server, therefore, we'll click on new database. This will install SQL Express database on this server. Enter credentials of user with which you are logged in. On configuring shadowing, we can see two options, that is, prohibit shadowing and allow shadowing. Shadowing allow remote of users. Please make a note, if you prohibit shadowing, then you cannot change it after Citrix is configured. I'll suggest to allow the shadowing even if you don't want to use it. Select allow and click on next. On the advanced server setting window, you can change the name of default zone. Zone is like a geographical locations. We'll talk more about zones in future videos. For this practical, we'll leave it default. You can recall that we integrated XML service with IIS while installing Citrix XenApp. That's the reason XML service is taking port number 80 and we cannot change it. As we have not created any web interface URL, therefore, we don't have any URL to specify in receiver. Define the remote desktop users to whom you wanted to grant access of published applications. As we only want authenticated users to access published applications, therefore, we'll uncheck first two options and select Add the authenticated users. Click Next to configure the server. On the Configure Server, we can see that it will install SQL Server Express, create data store, initialize Citrix Datastore, etc. Configuration will take a while. I'll fast forward this installation. Citrix XenApp 6.5 server is configured successfully. Reboot is required to complete the configuration. Congratulations for your first Citrix installation and configuration. In the next video, we'll learn the steps of configuring web interface and publish applications on Citrix XenApp server. If you like this video, then please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Bye, keep smiling, and have fun.